Hello Techies, in this tutorial we will learn how to set up and configure Azure DevOps REST API for the work item management project. To create Azure DevOps REST API, we need Azure subscription as a prerequisite. Alright, first of all we'll see what is REST API. REST API stands for Representational State Transfer API, which are having service endpoints that supports set of HTTP operations or methods which provide create, retrieve, update, or delete access to the service resources. Alright, now we'll see how to create Azure DevOps REST API for work item management project. Let's go to the browser and after that we'll log in into dev.azure.com. And then we are going to create a new organization. Click on new organization. And I'm going to click on continue. And I'm going to give the name of the organization as Learning Technologies. And then click on create. Now, a new organization with the name of Learning Technologies tool has created successfully. Now, we are going to create a project for that one. I will say the name of the project as Milestone. And then I'm going to click on private and then I'm going to click on create project. Now, if you see my organization as well as my project has created successfully. Now, to access this entire project by using REST API, we need to create a token. Okay, first of all, we'll see what are the work items that we have over here. Now, let's go to the boards and after select work items. There you can see I'm having zero records or zero work items right now in my particular project. Now, to access this project outside of the organization, we need to create public access token. How can we go ahead and do that? On the right hand side, you will find user settings. Click on that. And after that, you can see personal access token. Let's click on that. Now, we'll see what is this personal access token or public access token. An access token contains claims that you can use in Azure Active Directory to identify the granted permission to your API. When calling a resource server, an access token must be present in the HTTP request. Access token having token scopes that grant access to different actions. Scopes provide a way to manage permissions to protected resources. When an access token is requested, the client application needs to specify the desired permission in the scope parameter of the request. Token scope defines which Azure API can be accessed by a token, as well as which methods can be used to access those APIs. Access tokens have either public or secret scopes. All right, now what we are going to do, we are going to create a personal access token by using public. All right, I have already created a new token, but still, let's click on new token to create a new token for the particular project. I'm going to say Milestone, the name of the token. And after that, you can see the organization. I have given it as Learning Technologies Tool. And the expiration, I'm going to give it as 30 days. Or else, if you see over here, the organization, I can say all accessible organizations, I'm going to give it. And after that, the scopes, if you see over here, I'm going to give it read and write, all the work items, code, build, and releases also I'm going to give it. Now coming to the connected service, I'm going to connect the service. And after that, and I'm going to select the environment over here, read and manage. Extension data, I'm going to give it read and write. I'm going to give the identity as read and manage. Pull request threads, I'm going to give it as read and write. Secure files, read, create, and manage. Security, I'm going to make it as manage. And service connections, I'm going to make it as read, query, and manage. You can see over here, token administration, I'm going to give it as read and manage. All right, once you have given the required permissions for the personal access token, then I'm going to click on create. Now, I'm going to copy this token. Let's copy to clipboard. And then I'm going to the notepad. And then I'm going to paste it the token. All right. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on close. Now, let me go back to Azure DevOps. And there, once again, if you see on the milestones, this is the organizational name, Learning Technologies Tool. And after that, this is my project, right? Whenever you're going to give the URL, you have to understand this thing. In the URL, you have to give the organization name as well as project name and the areas you will get it while calling the projects. Now, our Azure DevOps REST API has created successfully. Now, how would I know or how can I test my API has created successfully or not? Now, there is a syntax over there in such a way, you will find https://dev.azure.com/organization, and after that you want to give the project, and after that you have to give APIs with work items and the type of task you can give it. In a such a way, type means you will give task, issue, or epic, you can give it. Now, if you see over here, I'm already having https://dev.azure.com/organization name as learning technologies tool slash project name is milestone. Let me copy this and then I'm going to paste it over here. Slash, I'm going to give /WIT/work items. And after that, I need to give the task or the type over here. I'm going to give it as task. And then I'm going to give question mark over here or query string. I'm going to give it as API-version = 6.0. 6.0 is the latest version which we have. Let me copy this. And then I'm going to paste it in the new URL. Let me paste that and then click on enter. There you can see the request has been created successfully. And there you can see the fields. I can see it as task, area path as milestone. And after that, display name over here, you can see it. And after that, all the details related to the API has provided over here in the particular request. All right. Now I'm going to change it if I want to get it, the epics over there. In such a case, I'm going to change the type as epic, and then I'm going to click on enter. Now you can see the request and response has been created successfully. Now, how can I know these types over here? How can we get the types over here? Right? If you go to the project once again, and then if you go to the work items from the dashboard, from the boards, and then click on work items, there you can see I'm having new work item. Let's drop down that. There you can see I'm having epic, issue, task, right? Now I am having issue, so that I will make it one more change over here to make you understand. If I'm going to pass it as type as issue. Now you can see the response over here. System.workItemType = issue. Now this is the way how you are going to pass the URL from the Power Automate desktop to invoke the web service. All right. Now we have created the public access token or personal access token. We have created that. Now, whenever you are going to call the Azure DevOps REST API by using invoke web service in the Power Automate desktop, these are the components you have to request and the response pair. There you can see the first one is that URL that which we have seen it right now, right? We have given the URL. In a such a way, dev.azure.com/organization name/project, and then you have to give the types over there. And there you can see the method over here. We are having a lot of methods for the REST API. That is get, post, connect, head, put, delete, option. These are all the methods which we are going to pass it. And after that, you can see the accept on which type. It should be a JSON format or whatnot, in the XML format or text format. Which format it is going to be accepting this URL. And the content type, the output which we are going to get it, right? There you can see I'm having application/json-patch+json. I'm going to get it as an output. Now, I will come to the custom headers. Now, if you see the request body over here, I'm going to give the request body in a such a way. I'm going to give the request body in a such a way. There you can see I'm going to add a new work item with the system title in the fields as current item of 2. It is nothing but I'm going to give the title over there which is coming from the Excel sheet. And after that, I'm going to pass the system description as well as iteration path from the Excel. All right, this is all the things we are going to give it in the request body. Now, coming to the custom headers, we are going to give the tokens over here. We are not directly going to give the token over here in such a way, authorization basic. And after that, we're not going to be giving the token over here, which we have already copied over here. There you can see I have copied the public access token or personal access token, right? We can't provide directly over here. The reason is that we need to convert this token into base64 string. Then only we can go ahead and we can utilize it in the custom headers as authorization basic, and then we are going to give the converted base64 string. Now, how can we convert the token into base64 token? Now I'm going to give the URL over here in the description also, that is base64.encode.org. Now, over here, I'm going to give the token. I'm going to paste the token over here. Before that, as a prefix, I need to give double dots to convert this token into encoded format. All right. Now let's click on encode. Now, this is the code which I am going to give it in the custom headers. Let me paste over here once again. Now, this is the custom header authorization token with base64 I'm going to give it. Now, what is the use of this base64 string? If you wish to provide the personal access token through HTTP headers, you must first convert the token into base64 string. The resulting string can be provided at the HTTP header in the given format. Once the token has been converted into base64 string, then in the custom headers, you are going to provide authorization basic, and then you are going to give it the base64 string token over here to access the APIs or Azure DevOps REST APIs. All right. In the next tutorial, we will learn how to connect Azure DevOps REST API by creating a desktop flow. And also we will learn how to add work items to Azure boards by using invoke web service action.